En couture. Please, be seated.
The court is now back in session.
L'audience est ouverte.
As we indicated this morning, before the break,
comme précisé ce matin,
for this afternoon session,
avant la pause,
we will hear the testimony of the
la chambre
witness,
entendra la déposition TCW
277 through video conferencing from France.
Depuis la France.
Mr. Da'an San, is the video conferencing
greffier
been set up?
Le lien vidéoconférence
Da'an
est-il en
San,
place?
Mr. President,
le greffier,
the technical team
Monsieur
reports that the linkage has been set up and the witness is awaiting the trial chamber's call. President, thank you.
Et le témoin attend l'appel de la chambre.
Good afternoon, Mr. Witness.
Le président. Bonjour, Monsieur le témoin.
Bonjour, Monsieur le président.
Good afternoon, Mr. President.
Thank you, Mr. Witness.
Président. Merci, Monsieur le témoin.
Could you tell us your full name?
Pourriez-vous décliner votre identité?
Monsieur le Président, je m'appelle Philippe Julien Gaufres.
Mr. President, my name is Philippe Julien Gaufres. I was born on the 24th of February 1930 in France.
Thank you, Mr. Philippe Gaufres.
Merci, Monsieur Philippe Gaufres.
As a witness to testify before this trial chamber,
vous
you are required to take an oath or affirmation based on your religion. Do you
Et
consent
vous devez
to that?
Prêter serment conformément à votre religion. Êtes-vous d'accord?
Je suis d'accord pour prêter un serment
yes.
laïque.
I wish to provide an oath.
Thank you.
Le président, merci.
Miss Miriam Mafesanti, could you please lead the witness to take an oath based on his religion?
Veuillez permettre au témoin de prêter
Monsieur
serment
le témoin,
conformément à sa religion.
S'il vous plaît, répétez après moi.
Mr. Witness, would you please repeat after me?
Je peux répéter après vous.
The witness, I shall.
Je déclare solennellement.
I solemnly declare.
Que je dirai la vérité.
And that I shall speak the truth.
Toute la vérité.
Oh, excusez-moi.
The witness, pardon me. I solemnly declare that.
Que je dirai la vérité. Toute
that
la vérité.
I shall speak the truth, the entire truth, and nothing but the truth.
Que je dirai toute
that
la vérité,
I shall speak
rien que la vérité.
The truth and nothing but the truth.
Thank you.
Le président, merci.
Mr. Philippe Gaufres, based on the report
Monsieur
by the greffier this morning, to the best of your knowledge and ability, do you have no relationship by blood
Le
or by law to any of the civil parties
de
in this case,
avec des
nor
parties civiles
through
à
any
ce
of the two accused, that is Nunji and Kirsampon? Is that correct?
Est-ce exact?
C'est exact, Monsieur le Président.
Mr. President, that is correct.
Thank you.
Merci.
We would like now to inform you of your rights and obligation as a witness.
Nous tenons maintenant à vous
Mr.
informer de
Philippe
vos droits
Gaufres,
et de vos obligations
as a witness
témoin,
before this chamber, you may
chambre,
refuse to respond to any question
à des questions
that may incriminate you.
qui risquerait de vous
incriminer. As for your obligation as a witness,
pour ce qui a de vos obligations en tant
to
que
testify
témoin
before this court,
déposant devant cette chambre,
you must respond to all the questions put to you by any of the parties or judges of the bench,
and
you must only speak of the truth that you have heard, have known, have experienced or recalled
directly
related to the events concerning the questions put to you by judges of the bench or any of the parties. Do you understand that?
Oui, Monsieur le Président.
Yes, Mr. President.
Thank you.
Merci.
Had you been interviewed by the office of the
avez-vous été interrogé par le bureau des co-juges d'instruction des CETC?
Non. Non, Monsieur le Président, je n'ai pas été interrogé.
No, Mr. President, I have not been interviewed previously.
Thank you.
Merci.
As this witness is the witness requested by Kills and Pawns team,
ce témoin
he,
est appelé par
the team,
la défense de Kyo
team, I mean, would have the would
raison,
be given the floor first.
La défense de Kyo Sampan aura la parole en premier.
To put question to this witness, you have 1 hour and 15 minutes to do so.
Pendant une heure et quart.
And likewise for the prosecution and the
L'accusation
litigal lawyers, you would have
1 hour
and 15 minutes time allocation for this witness. You may proceed.
Merci, Monsieur le Président. Bonjour, Monsieur Julien.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Je suis Arthur Verken, un des avocats.
My name is Arthur Verken. I am one of the lawyers representing Mr. Kyo Sampan.
Pour commencer, je voudrais que vous indiquiez à la Chambre votre parcours universitaire puis professionnel,
academic and professional background.
Dans les grandes lignes, bien évidemment.
Obviously, I will be providing the broad outlines of your academic qualifications. Answer. I pursued my studies at the École des Hautes Études, the Business Management School in Paris. I was also a student at the National School of Oriental Languages. I worked in banks, and I also worked in the Far East between 1955 and 1956. I returned to France, and as I had met many students from the Far East and students from Cambodia during my business studies, I decided to return to Cambodia to work. So upon my return to France, I decided to enroll in courses at the National School of Oriental Languages, and I learned to speak, read, and write the Cambodian language. I graduated from that school in 1960. That is my educational background. In addition to my degree, I was also employed in several French and Cambodian businesses, and I worked in Cambodia, and I was able to find work in the multinational company Air Liquide. And I worked in Cambodia as the managing director of the subsidiary of the international group Air Liquide. I also worked in Malaysia and Thailand, and I returned to France, where I continued my career with Air Liquide, and I was also managing director there. When I retired some 20 years ago, I joined an NGO that is dedicated to providing technical assistance to emerging and developing countries. And in that non-governmental organization, I am responsible for relations with the Far East. My relationship with the Far East had begun very long time ago. I studied civilization and culture of the Far East, which was of great interest to me, as I found it to be of significant contrast to the values here in France. And as I said, it was just after the war, the United States was considered as a model. However, I personally found inspiration in the Oriental and Asian culture and civilization.
Je vous remercie.
Thank you very
much. Vous avez
much.
Dit que votre premier séjour au Cambodge avait eu lieu
Cambodia
dans les années 1955-56. Pouvez-vous préciser à quelle occasion vous aviez séjourné dans ces années au Cambodge?
What brought you to Cambodia during those years? Answer. I completed my military training in the French Navy. I spent 2 years in Europe and 1 year in the Far East, and it was during 1955-1956, shortly after the signing of the Geneva Accords, and I was sent there to resolve certain issues in the Far East. I was based in Saigon, in Vietnam. I undertook a certain number of missions in Cambodia and in Hong Kong and in the Philippines. I therefore made three trips, first in my capacity as a soldier, following that in my capacity as a private citizen. Council Verken,
vous avez indiqué que vous êtes ensuite revenu au Cambodge dans le cadre de votre activité professionnelle au sein de l'entreprise Air Liquide. Est-ce qu'en deux mots, vous pouvez nous dire quel est le domaine d'activité de cette société et quel était son domaine d'activité au Cambodge?
Answer. Air Liquide is an industrial group that was established in 1902. Some 110, 112 years ago. Its main mission is the manufacturing of industrial gases and medical gases, such as oxygen, hydrogen, argon. It also produces material for the production of those gases. Air Liquide was the first world multinational group based on its profits alone. In Cambodia, it had several production units for the manufacturing of the oxygen, as well as carbonic substances and other medical substances such as peroxide, etc.
Dans le cadre de votre travail au sein de la société Air Liquide au Cambodge, avez-vous été basé spécifiquement dans ce pays, et si oui, pendant quelle période?
In this country, and if so, during which period? Answer. When I first applied for a position within Air Liquide, I did mention that I very much wish to be assigned to Cambodia. And at the time, Air Liquide was in the midst of broadening its activities in the country by establishing a new factory and mounting a new company called Sokia, which was held 25% by the Cambodian government, 49% by Air Liquide, and 26% by private individuals, mostly Cambodians. I was the managing director. The president of the company was designated by the Cambodian government I therefore served under Mr. Sun Vansai, who had studied
Monsieur
in
Julien.
France. Interruption, Council Verken, Mr.
Puis-je
Julien.
Me permettre de vous interrompre, car je ne dispose
Pardon
pas d'énormément de temps.
You, unfortunately, I don't have
les détails que
much
vous vous apprêtiez à donner
disposal,
sont peut-être un tout petit peu superflus.
Some of the details
je,
that you are providing,
je vous remercie d'avoir été jusque-là, mais voulu connaître la période durant laquelle vous avez été
so
en poste au
there.
Cambodge pour
I
l'air liquide.
To, just return to the period when you were assigned in Cambodia and working for Air Liquide. Answer, I was there in 1955 to 1956, as well as in 1957, and then I returned to Cambodia in mission in 1974 for the period of 1 month approximately. Council Verken.
Nous dire si aujourd'hui vous avez encore des activités en rapport avec l'Asie ou plus précisément le Cambodge. Vous avez évoqué une ONG ou une activité associative. Pouvez-vous donner des détails?
Business relations or other relations in Cambodia or the Far East. Answer. My main relation with Cambodia is through my wife. When I was in Cambodia, I married a Cambodian woman. We have four children. My wife and I have traveled to Cambodia over the past years. But in my capacity as a volunteer for the NGO, my activity is focused mainly on China. And therefore, my work for the non-governmental organization is mostly to do with China. And through my wife, I do maintain several contacts with Cambodians who are either in France, living in France, or traveling through France.
Je vous remercie.
Question. Thank you.
Je vais maintenant revenir à l'origine de votre intérêt pour le Cambodge. Et peut-être pouvez-vous expliquer à la Chambre la manière dont vous avez approfondit votre connaissance de ce pays alors que vous faisiez vos études en France, au sein, donc, vous l'avez dit, de l'école des langues orientales.
Je vais peut-être revenir un tout petit peu en arrière et parler de mes études à l'école des hautes études.
I'll have to move back a bit further and start with my studies at the business school where I first came into contact with Cambodian students. And in my graduating class, there were two Cambodians. Now I will attempt to be brief.
After
1955, after my return from Cambodia, I came to the decision of wanting to move to Cambodia, and therefore I signed up for language courses, which were mainly literature courses and conversation courses. And I was assisted by Cambodian students who were in Paris. I was therefore assisted by the Khmer Students Union, which at the time was presided over by Mr. Khieu Sompong. I asked him to put me into contact with one or two Cambodian students who were living in Paris and with whom I could exchange and practice conversational skills, and which would allow them, in turn, to improve their French through our conversations.
Et cette rencontre avec Monsieur Khieu Sompong a eu lieu à Paris et en quelle année?
Did the encounter with Mr. Khieu Sompong occur in Paris?
Answer,
that meeting took place at the Cité Universitaire, at the student residence in 1957, when I began my language courses. Perhaps at the end of 1957, at the start of 1958, my memory is not totally clear.
Pouvez-vous,
Council Verken,
dire à la Chamber si, par la suite, mis à part cette première rencontre avec M. Khieu Sompong, vous avez rencontré à nouveau M. Khieu Sompong pendant les années qui ont suivi?
During the years that followed. And so when he was in Paris, I had the opportunity to meet Mr. Kyo-Sampan during certain demonstrations that had been organized by the student body organization that he was in charge of. I also had private meetings with him because as I sought to move to Cambodia and I knew that he was writing a thesis on economics and I was working in the industry, I thought it was rather useful and constructive for me to engage in conversations with him. I went to Cambodia in 1971. Counsel Verken, I must interrupt you. In order for your testimony to be absolutely clear, let us focus on the French period. You've just stated that you met Mr. Kyo-Sampan at the Cité Universitaire,
plusieurs reprises,
at the university, and you met him there on several occasions, and that you held several conversations with him on the topic of economics. Is that correct? Answer, yes, that is correct. They weren't really conversations. It was during a symposium that was organized in the month of March 1959. And at that symposium, there were invited representatives from former French territories of Indochina. There was a Vietnamese person, a Laotian person, and a Cambodian representative, who was Kyo-Sampan. The theme, the subject of that symposium was foreign investment and local investment in each of those countries. Therefore, each of the representatives spoke on behalf of their countries.
Nous disposons au dossier de
on the case file,
une déposition écrite, témoignage écrit et signé de vous, porte une cote qui est la cote E190 barre de fraction 2.5.
It is under E190/1.5.
Attaché à cette déposition écrite d'une dizaine de pages, il y a une photocopie de notes manuscrites. Il est indiqué « Notes prises pendant l'exposé de M. Kyo-Sampan sur les investissements au Cambodge lors d'un colloque sur les pays de l'ancienne Indochine française organisé à Paris le 3 mars 1959. Êtes-vous l'auteur de ces notes ?»
Are you indeed the author of those notes?
Je suis l'auteur de ces notes.
Answer, I am indeed the author of those notes. And I'm rather surprised to see that I managed to retrieve them.
Est-ce que vous avez pu les relire récemment?
Question, were you able to read them recently? Answer, yes.
Et comment décririez-vous,
question, and how would you
à travers, bien évidemment, cette relecture et peut-être aussi le souvenir que vous en avez,
based on your memory and based on your rereading of these notes,
leur contenu?
How would you describe
quel type de thèse était développé par M. Kyo-Sampan lors de ce colloque donc sur les investissements au Cambodge?
During that presentation on investments in Cambodia. Answer. He talked mainly about the transformation of a colonial type economy.
Des matières premières qu'il trouve dans le pays, dans
whereby
colonie,
a foreign country brings in material
à ce pays des produits finis.
And or exploits the local commodities in order to manufacture finished products. And therefore, his thesis was on the country's resources, Cambodia's main industries, which were wood, rubber, agriculture. According to Mr. Kyo-Sampan, it was necessary to develop the industry in order to foster valorization and promote the local Cambodian economy. He also talked about state intervention. However, he did not talk about absolute and total intervention, as he made very specific that instilling fear in foreign investors had to be averted
l'industrialisation.
It was important for the industrialization
le financement des infrastructures nécessaires, routes, aéroports,
of the country and building necessary infrastructure to support development.
Dans les notes,
I remember
que
seeing in my notes that Mr. Kyusampan concluded his presentation by saying that he wished for the economic independence for Cambodia and not autarky.
Voilà, en résumé.
That, in
Alors,
summary, is what the
presentation
was
about. Counselor Erkin,
indeed, sir.
Une photocopie de ces notes au dossier, je vais
We
en donner les codes ERN pour les transcrits. En français, c'est la cote 008-09-334. En Khmer, 00-09-07-7-7-1. Et en anglais,
009-11-42.
Et pour ce qui est des investissements étrangers, je relève que sur une des pages de vos notes manuscrites, il est indiqué monopole d'État du commerce extérieur risque de décourager les capitaux privés. Un peu plus loin, à la page qui est à moitié couverte de vos notes, il est indiqué effectivement,
notes,
et c'est la dernière phrase, autonomie et non autarcie. Cela confirme donc ce que vous venez de dire sur l'esprit de l'intervention
about,
ce 3 mars 1959 de M. Kyusampan. C'est bien cela?
Is this correct answer? Yes, that is correct.
Est-ce que la teneur des propos qu'a tenu en public ce jour-là M. Kyusampan correspondait avec les entretiens privés que vous nous avez dit avoir eu avec lui?
Answer. Absolutely. The only difference being that the symposium was dedicated to investments, the topic of investments. However, in private conversation, Mr. Kyusampan talks extensively about social issues. He said that the economy had to be developed. However, simultaneously, there had to be an improvement of the standard of living of Cambodians, in particular the standard of living of peasants. I had other conversations with him on that very topic when I was in Cambodia, perhaps something that we can visit later on.
Au cours des conversations que vous avez
eues
avec M.
Kyusampan
en France et lors des propos lors de ce colloque, est-ce qu'il a été question d'abolition de la propriété privée ou de la suppression de la possibilité de posséder des biens matériels ou voire de l'abolition de la monnaie? Était-ce des propos qui ont été tenus par M. Kyusampan, des propositions qu'il aurait faites?
What kind of statements or ideas did Mr. Kyusampan share? Answer. Quoi?
Si vous deviez
I do not remember.
Oui, merci, Monsieur le Président. Maître Verken,
yes, thank you, Mr. President.
Respecter un temps entre les questions et les réponses. Je crois que les interprètes ont beaucoup de mal
to have a bit of a time gap between the questions and the answers, because it's very difficult for the interpreters to latch on. So it might be good to stand by this rhythm,
and
your volume is very high, and the volume coming from the video link is very low, so all of this makes things, technically speaking, a bit difficult for the interpreter, so I'd like simply to draw your attention on that. Thank you.
Oui, moi-même, je m'assourdis un peu.
Yes, yes, I also deafened myself a little bit.
Mais est-ce qu'il y a peut-être, well, Monsieur le Juge, un passage
Honor,
a, vous savez qu'il n'a pas été traduit
maybe
correctement
one segment that was not properly translated that I should get back to?
Non, pas à ma connaissance. De
not as far as I remember, says Judge Laven. I'm just trying to warn you for the rest of this.
Je vais y prendre garde.
Examination.
Je vous remercie.
I'll pay attention to this, says Counsel Bakken.
Donc,
thank you. So,
si vous deviez, Monsieur Julien, résumer de quelques mots
le
type de proposition qui était faite à cette époque par Monsieur
Quesampan,
comment le feriez-vous? S'agissait-il, par exemple, d'un discours qui vous avait semblé gauchiste?
Were his statements rather left-leaning, you would say,
modéré?
Or was he more middle ground?
Quelle est votre compréhension du discours de Monsieur Quesampan à cette époque?
Your impression of Quesampan's statements back then? I would say that what he was saying was not revolutionary. But however, back then, that is to say, more than 60 years ago, it was rather innovative. But I would say, in today's terms, in regard to French political parties, I would say that it was more socialistic in leaning.
Alors,
so,
j'en viens maintenant.
Now, let me turn.
À parler de la période durant laquelle vous vous êtes installé au Cambodge.
When you settled in Cambodia, you said
cette installation avait eu lieu en 1961. Qu'elle avait été régulière jusqu'en 1966.
And that you remained in Cambodia
à travers des missions plus ponctuel, en
later
tout cas, pour
on,
ce qui concerne
you went
Cambodge.
There on more punctual missions.
Pourriez-vous
so
nous dire
could you
si
tell us,
pendant cette période qui va de 1961
during this period from 1961
à 1966, jusqu'en 1974,
and then
je
up
crois,
until 1974, if I'm correct,
vous avez revu Monsieur Quesampan.
Can you tell us if you saw Mr. Quesampan again
au Cambodge?
In Cambodia. Yes, I saw him in Cambodia upon several occasions between 1961 and 1966. And I saw him again because I went to see him at his home, and I got to know his mother and his brothers, and we met upon several occasions, and once, in fact, I had invited him to come visit the factory I was in charge of, and then he made a little speech then for the staff at the factory. And the factory workers very much appreciated it, and my staff thanked me for having invited him. And Quesampan, who was a parliamentarian then, had become Minister of Commerce then. And
les grandes lignes,
basically
quelle était
speaking,
la teneur de ce discours?
What was the substance of this speech he made? Well, the substance of this speech, I don't know it because he had given this speech in Khmer. My knowledge of Khmer was not sufficient back then to understand a political or economic speech of that nature, but through conversations that I had had before and afterwards, I know that he was very much interested in social issues, in the standard of living of the people, and he wanted the peasants to sell their produce at acceptable prices, and he wanted them to obtain credits easily with reasonable interest rates, which was not the case back then, and he also We also wanted people to take into account health issues, education, training, and I also know that he defended the interests of the people from the area he had been elected, and he tried to protect them from abuse, from abusive behavior from rich traders, and he also wanted to fight against corruption and against abuse of power.
Alors, est-ce que tout ce que vous venez de dire correspond également à des discussions que vous-même avez pu avoir en français avec Monsieur Champan à cette époque?
Back then. Yes. What I said, of course, results from discussions I had had with him, either at his home, at the factory, or elsewhere.
Vous venez d'indiquer que pendant cette période de 1961 à 1966, vous avez été reçu chez
Monsieur
Champan.
Est-ce
que vous pourriez nous donner des informations, des détails sur le train de vie de Monsieur Champan à cette époque,
back then,
la manière dont il était logé, la manière dont il se déplaçait?
Well, his lifestyle was very modest. When I went to Cambodia in 1961, I went to visit him, and he was living with his mother in a very small house on stilts, built out of wood, covered with wood shingles. And a few years later, he moved, and he moved to a very modest apartment in brick, however. Even though while he was Minister of Commerce, he didn't use a bike as transportation, but he used a car, but it was a second-hand car only, that was very, very modest. And his lifestyle was always very, very, very simple.
Est-ce que dans le cadre de vos activités professionnelles au sein de l'entreprise Air Liquide pendant ces années, vous étiez amené à fréquenter la classe politique cambodgienne?
Were you ever led to interact with the Cambodian political class? Yes, because first of all, the president of my company had been appointed by the government. That was, he was the former head of the Cambodian Railroad, who then became Cambodian ambassador to Washington, and the second president at that company was Mr. Mao Tsa, who had been the minister of planification. So, among the private shareholders as well, there were businessmen and politicians. There was, for example, a former prime minister and members of the royal family, and Cyric Matak. And therefore, through my professional activities, I was in contact with the Ministry of Industry and the Ministry of Commerce.
La simplicité du train de vie
and
de Monsieur Khieu Sampan à cette époque contrastait-elle avec
Khieu Sampan's lifestyle
la manière
back then?
Dont vivait la classe politique que vous pouviez rencontrer et connaître par ailleurs?
The political class that you might have met elsewhere?
Eh bien,
well, in this political class, you had former figures from the Democratic Party who had been eliminated from political life by Sihanouk, but who had become traders and who were living decently, and you also had people who were in power whose lifestyle was probably rather sumptuous, at least in certain cases.
Est-ce que vous pourriez rapidement nous brosser
a general idea of the economic situation of Cambodia
à la veille de la prise du pouvoir par les Khmer Rouges? Vous avez une activité professionnelle intense au Cambodge jusqu'en 1966. Vous avez continué à vous y rendre pour des raisons professionnelles.
You lived in Cambodia until 1966, and you kept on traveling to Cambodia until 1974. So, if you were to describe in very broad terms the economic situation of Cambodia,
quel serait le dessin que vous en brosseriez?
What would you tell us? Well, there were efforts to industrialize the country with the foreign support, in particular from China. China built four factories in Cambodia, a cement plant, a conglomerate wood plant, a paper mill, and a fourth plant I don't remember. And these plants were more or less operational. And the situation, economic situation in Cambodia is, as I said to you earlier on, was rather colonial. Their main resource was products, was rubber of excellent quality, but that was not processed on site. In 1963, when Norodom Sihanouk met or accepted American aid, with the hope of developing a more national center economy. But the results were not that fantastic. However, the peasants were fed. Through their work, they could eat. There were people who were poor, but nobody was living in dire misery. But however, some people were getting very, very rich thanks to trading, international trading, or thanks to activities connected with the infrastructure. So, the economic situation was the economic situation of a country that was not yet developed, basically speaking.
Au regard de la formation qui était la vôtre et de la connaissance intime que vous aviez des conditions économiques du Cambodge, est-ce que les propositions
do you believe that the reform proposals made by Mr. Kyesampan
vous paraissaient rationnels et raisonnables, realistic
and reasonable and desirable even? Well, his proposals seemed reasonable because what he was seeking was to value the resources in the country in order to usher in a more developed economy and a higher standard of living for the peasants and workers.
J'imagine que vous n'êtes pas revenu au Cambodge pendant la période
Democratic Kampuchea. That's so. I only returned to Cambodia in 2005 for personal reasons.
Comment avez-vous compris l'implication de Monsieur Kyesampan
dans ce régime? You perceive Kyesampan's involvement in the Democratic Kampuchea regime?
Well,
the role that Mr. Que Sampan played was set up by people who were in power in Democratic Kampuchea because they needed a head of state who was popular and who was respectable. So they had first chosen Prince Norodom Sihanouk as head of state, who was very popular, of course, and who was known throughout the world. But when they wanted to change heads of state after a year, they thought about Que Sampan because he was very popular. François Ponchot, in one of his books on the history of Cambodia, says that Que Sampan was the idol, the icon idol for the youth, therefore he was a respected figure. He had a PhD in economics that he had earned in France. He spoke French, one of the five languages of the official languages of the UN. He was known by foreign embassies in Cambodia because he was a parliamentarian as well as a minister. And when he disappeared with Hu Yun and Hu Nim in 1957, a lot of people in Cambodia spoke about this in the embassies and in the private sector and in the papers. So, therefore, he was someone who was popular, who was respected and known. So, I believe that is why he was chosen as head of state for Democratic Kampuchea.
Vous avez indiqué,
and you said
tout à l'heure que
earlier
vous étiez revenu au Cambodge,
you had returned to Cambodia
dans les années 2000,
in the year 2000,
around,
and you said in 2005, in fact,
peut-être aussi en 2006,
and maybe 2006 as well.
À ces occasions,
and
ou peut-être
during those
même
trips,
avant,
or even maybe before,
mais en tout cas après la fin du régime du Kampuchea démocratique,
after the fall of Democratic Kampuchea,
vous avez revu M. Que Sampan.
Did you see Que Sampan again? Yes, I saw Mr. Que Sampan in 1990. He was traveling through Paris. He was staying at the Place de Barcelone, where the coalition government of Democratic Kampuchea had its offices, that was presided over by Norodom Sihanouk, and the Prime Minister was His Excellency Son Sann, and Que Sampan was Deputy Prime Minister and Minister of Foreign Affairs. And I saw him as well in Beijing by chance in 1992. And in 2005 and in 2006, I traveled to Cambodia twice, and I, yes, spent a few days with him. And in 2005, I stayed with him at his home in Pai Lin. I saw his old house, which was also a wood shingle house, which I... Of course, he had found a brick house, but that was not very, very comfortable. And I don't believe that there was running water in this house. And the following year, in 2006, we traveled together to An Long Veng, where his elder son was living, and we had lunch with his elder son, who was living in a very, very simple house. And his elder son would sell gasoline for moped drivers, and he was living above the shop. And then I went to Prévihir with him to visit the temple, and we stopped several times along the way in different villages. And I saw that the villagers still had a lot of respect for Monsieur Que Sampan.
Vous avez indiqué avoir revu Monsieur Chassampan en 1990 à Paris. Vous savez ce qu'il faisait.
What he was doing there? I believe that he was traveling to different countries back then to prepare what was known later as the Paris Peace Agreement. I know that he traveled to Africa then as well, and one of my Thai friends, who was the Thai ambassador to Kenya, had met him. And I believe they discussed the situation in Cambodia following the invasion of Cambodia by Vietnam, and they discussed Thailand's stance vis-à-vis Cambodia, but I don't know the details of their discussion. But and I saw the ambassador in Kenya, and he told me that he had been very, very impressed by Chassampan's character.
Je n'ai pas d'autres questions, Monsieur
I have
President.
No further questions, Mr. Monsieur President. Julien. Thank you very much, Mr. Julien.
Merci.
Thank you.
The President.
Le Président.
Thank you, Counsel.
Merci, Maître.
Judge Lavergne, you may now proceed.
Juge Lavergne, je vous en prie.
Oui, merci,
yes,
Monsieur le
thank
Président.
You, Mr. President.
Bonjour,
Good
Monsieur
afternoon,
Julien
Goffre.
Je suis le juge Lavergne,
one of the international judges, and I have a few questions to
Tout
put to you.
Je First of all, que nous puissions revenir
I would like
sur
us to return to your first encounters with Mr.
Chassampan
in the 1950s.
Est-ce que vous pourriez nous dire si dans les conversations que vous avez eues avec M.
Chassampan,
vous avez eu des conversations à teneur politique?
If there was anything political about these conversations?
Alors, Monsieur le juge,
well, Your Honor, I only had a few conversations with Mr. Chassampan because he left France in May 1959. So it was only in 58 that I spoke to him, and we did not speak in detail about political issues. However, I understood then that he desired that Cambodia develop towards a democratic and republican democratic regime, and I believe that he wished that this change would happen gradually and not in a brutal way. He wanted to avoid revolution. He just wanted evolution.
Est-ce que Monsieur Chassampan vous a
Question.
Indiqué
Did Mr. Chassampan
que
tell you
depuis 1957, il avait fait partie d'un cercle
qui s'appelait
le cercle d'études marxistes.
A circle called the circle of Marxist students
since 1957. S'il était inscrit au Parti communiste français, éventuellement,
whether or not he was a member of the French Communist Party and of which particular cell? No, he did not tell me about this.
Je suppose que dans le cadre des activités de l'Union des étudiants cambodgiens, vous avez dû rencontrer un certain nombre d'étudiants, de personnes de nationalité cambodgienne.
At the Union des étudiants cambodgiens,
vous avez notamment rencontré un monsieur qui s'appelait Ok Sakhun.
For example, did you meet in particular someone by the name of Ok Sakhun?
Je ne me souviens pas de ce nom-là.
I don't remember this name. It's possible that I met him because I met tens of Cambodian students in Paris.
Surtout à partir du moment où le Cambodge a édifié le pavillon du Cambodge.
Especially after the pavillon du Cambodge was built at the Cité Universitaire.
J'en ai connu beaucoup.
So yes, I met many Cambodian students, not all of them.
Est-ce que parmi question. Ces étudiants, Among vous en avez rencontré students, qui se sont ouvertement présentés comme étant d'obédience attirés par le Parti communiste?
They were communists or attracted to the Communist Party? Yes, answer. Yes, some told me that. And they told me that they had participated in the Communist International. The Communist International organized major gatherings in Prague and places like that. So, probably, I know that Cambodian students had participated in some of these gatherings, probably members of the Union des étudiants cambodgiens.
Selon vous, question, monsieur, que according to you, was personne que qui pouvait s'engager dans who could des mouvements,
join movements,
non pas par adhésion idéologique,
not because he was following their ideology necessarily,
patriotisme,
but because
pour,
of patriotic sentiment,
de lien,
or to act
pour être
as
utile.
A link, or to be useful in some way. Answer, I believe that Kyo Sampan, who was single back then, would spend most of his time focusing on the development of his country by being involved in activities of various kinds.
Mais,
his main goal was to improve the livelihood of the Cambodian population.
Alors, monsieur,
through economic development.
Monsieur
question.
Était entendu depuis le début de ce procès à plusieurs reprises.
Et
il a dit notamment ceci par rapport à son engagement au sein du cercle d'études marxistes.
Et
c'était lors de l'audience du 13 décembre 2011 à 14h20, c'est le document E1/21.1 et en français sont les ERN 00 76 19 46 à 50.
Et en anglais,
and in English,
0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 Mr. Yang Sari entrusted him with the responsibility of leading the circle des étudiants marxistes, and he said the following on the 13th of December 2011. He said that he accepted this task because those who were the most convinced had returned to Cambodia, and it was only he who could take charge of the circle.
And he saw in that the possibility of
achieving something that would be useful by inculcating patriotism to its members.
Voilà. Donc, c'est peut-être un peu plus qu'un rapprochement.
I believe it's a bit more than just coming close to the Communist Party, because Que Sampan was a member of the Communist Party in France. He said it, and on top of this, he is at the head of the circle of Marxist students, Cercle des étudiants marxistes. So, however, you said that he was more of a socialist. So, isn't there some kind of contradiction here?
Response.
As I stated earlier, the Socialist Party at the time was not the most active organization with respect to decolonization of former countries. Only the Communist Party was concerned with such issues, and I believe that Mr. Que Sampan held socialist-leaning economic ideas.
Judge Lavergne, do you know if among
socialist circles self-criticism was exercised? Was the notion of secrecy prevalent during the period?
Moreover, we are dealing with
the time of 1957 to 1959, and yet Cambodia had gained independence as of 1953.
Response. Firstly, I did not frequent the circles that you are talking about. Yes, the official independence of Cambodia occurred in 1954. However, from an economic stance, colonialism was still quite present up until the end of the 1950s to the start of the 1960s.
Est-ce que Judge Lavergne, travail do the words the work of United
Front evoke anything for you, Mr. Witness? Response.
No,
nothing at all.
S'agissant de l'image que M. Que Sampan pouvait donner de lui-même, j'ai retenu de ce que vous nous avez dit que M. Que Sampan était quelqu'un qui avait une image d'un homme très populaire, très respectable, sérieux, honnête. Est-ce qu'on peut dire aussi que c'était l'image d'un homme d'une certaine modération et l'image de quelqu'un qui inspirait la confiance and who à beaucoup de
was
milieux.
Very trustworthy among many people and circles. Response, absolutely. In fact, Mr. François Ponchot, in his book that I cited earlier, Mr. François Ponchot called Mr. Que Sampan a one-time Mr. Clean. He was someone that he did not share political views with necessarily. However, it does go to show that his popularity was quite great, as was his honesty and integrity, as well as his sense of social welfare.
Judge Lavergne,
if I understand correctly what you were telling the chamber, that is an image
qui a pu être utilisé par that le mouvement Khmer Rouge
could have been
pour inspirer lui-même
manipulated
confiance.
Or used by the Khmer Rouge in order to gain and build trust.
Alors, je voudrais que
answer,
nous passions maintenant
absolutely.
À
Judge
notre
Lavergne,
série de questions.
Let's move to
sont
another line of questioning,
vous,
which could potentially be more painful for you.
Au tribunal,
since in the document that you have provided to this tribunal,
qui est votre attestation, vous avez indiqué avoir perdu beaucoup de membres de votre belle famille et beaucoup de gens qui étaient aussi de vos amis.
family, you lost in-laws and you lost friends and colleagues. You lost your father-in-law, your sisters-in-law, her husband, four nephews. You state that you lost Cambodian friends such as Mr. In Sokan, Mr. In Sopan,
Monsieur Sion Cassette,
Mr. Sun Cassette,
Monsieur Dipon,
Tuk Kamdon,
est-ce que vous savez d'ailleurs ce qu'il est advenu de ces derniers?
Do you know what happened?
Est-ce que vous savez où ils sont morts? On se pense à Monsieur In Sopan, Monsieur Sun Cassette, Tom Kamdon,
do you know what happened to In Sokan, Sun Cassette, In Sopan, Tuk Kamdon? Response: I do not know the details. A very, very long time ago, I held in my hands a list of people who perished at S21. However, I do not recall who was on that list or who was not on that list. I cited a few names. All I know was that there were many friends who were no longer there in 1979. Judge Laverne.
Monsieur In Sopan
indeed,
a été détenu à S21.
Mr. In Sopan was detained at S21.
C'est l'entrée numéro 2989 de la liste révisée des prisonniers de S21.
He is on number 2989 of the S21 prisoners list submitted by the court prosecutors.
A également été
Mr.
détenu
Sin
à S21.
Cassette was also detained
C'est
at S21.
Numéro 10090 sur la même liste.
Number
Monsieur Tok Kamdon
a été également détenu à S21, c'est le numéro 10818.
Monsieur Dipon,
Mr. Dipon
a également été détenu à S21,
was a prisoner
c'est
at
le
S21.
Numéro 1937. Vous He avez également déclaré que parmi les personnes que vous n'avez plus revues,
and that among those friends you did not see again, there were also many cadres from your company,
Sokoa,
the Cambodian subsidiary of Air Liquide, who you did not see again. You referred to Tan Kim Yo, Niel Nani, Yu Yang.
Alors ma question est relativement simple. Est-ce que vous avez discuté avec Monsieur Kyo Sampan de ces disparitions? Est-ce que Monsieur Kyo Sampan, selon vous, connaissait Monsieur In Sokan, Monsieur In Sofan, Monsieur Sun Cassette, Monsieur Tok Kamdon, Monsieur Dipon,
In Sopan, Tok Kamdon? Dipon, response. Mr. Kyo Sampan knew those individuals. I think he knew them all because they studied in Paris when I was visiting the Cambodian pavilion at the University of Paris. I never talked about them because I only saw Mr. Kyo Sampan again in 1990 and 1992. I did not talk about the 1975 to 1979 period. Essentially, we talked about personal issues and we talked about our families. Our conversations were relatively brief. I considered that it wasn't appropriate for me to place this burden and to ask questions on that period, the period of 1975-1979, and of the events that took place then. I wanted to wait for the situation to dissipate. The newspapers and books had reported many things and things that called for
Monsieur Julien Goffre, vous n'ignorez pas que précisément ce qui nous intéresse au premier chef aujourd'hui, c'est cette période.
However, Mr. Witness, you must realize that our chief concern, the chief concern of this tribunal, is that very period, the 1975-1979 period. That
j'aimerais savoir aussi si M. Kyo Sampan vous a parlé de sa famille, parce que je crois que vous connaissiez un petit peu sa famille.
I believe that you were somewhat acquainted
sa mère, ses frères, ses sœurs. Est-ce que vous savez quelque chose à ce
Mr.
sujet?
Witness, do you know anything about his family ties? In response, during our meetings in 1990, it was then, during our conversations about family, that he told me that he lived he told me that his mother and his brother lived very far away from him and that they could not live close to each other, and he saw them on a very seldom and rare basis.
Il vous a dit exactement qu'il savait où ils étaient?
Did he tell you where his mother and brothers were?
Pendant cette période du Cambodge démocratique?
During that period of democratic Cambodia. Answer, I did not ask the question. I did not seek those kinds of details. What I did gather, and what I do believe, is that the two families of the two heads of states, be it Khieu Samphan or Prince Norodom Sihanouk, their families had not been spared. Within the family of Prince Norodom Sihanouk, I believe that he lost some 14 children and grandchildren, including Mr. Sisovat Sitovi. And I believe during the time that Mr. Khieu Samphan was head of state, his family did not enjoy any preferential treatment.
Donc, est-ce que vous pensez que vous pouvez mettre, comparer la position que tenait Norodom Sihanouk à la période du Cambodge démocratique à celle que tenait M. Khieu Samphan? Est-ce que vous savez si M. Khieu Samphan a siégé au comité central du Parti communiste du Cambodge démocratique?
I believe that both gentlemen served as heads of state. And in a country with a communist regime, a head of state plays a much more representative role and does not enjoy significant power. Take, for example, the Cultural Revolution who Mao Zedong eliminated. Everybody knew Kim Jong-un as the strong man. But Kim Jong-nam was head of state in North Korea, and in the North Korean constitution, similar to the constitution of Democratic Kampuchea, I believe that the role of the president of the presidium is a role that is akin to that of a figurehead. He only receives other heads of states, ambassadors, secretaries of state, etc. I can think of other examples.
Bien, donc ce que vous nous dites, c'est une analyse qui vous est personnelle et générale. Est-ce que vous avez eu à quelconque moment des discussions précises sur le rôle exact de M. Khieu Samphan pendant la période du Cambodge démocratique? Est-ce que vous avez des éléments d'information à nous apporter à ce sujet? Nous avons fait un certain nombre d'audiences que nous essayons de savoir ce qui s'est passé.
On that subject. Response, I do not know the facts. I did not have any in-depth conversations on that topic. I knew Mr. Khieu Samphan since 1957. However, I do not know the details of his life, particularly of his life during the 1975-1979 period. I am not in a position to answer.
Dans votre témoignage, Monsieur Julien Goffre, vous avez déclaré avoir été très choqué par la lecture de la Constitution du Cambodge démocratique et notamment par la lecture de l'article 3 de cette Constitution. Est-ce que vous vous souvenez de ce que dit cet article 3 de la Constitution du Cambodge démocratique?
Response, no, not exactly.
Pardon. C'est l'article qui traite de la culture.
The article on culture. Response, oh yes. Yes, now that you make mention of it, I do recall.
The Constitution
states that the previous culture and civilization of Cambodian up until 1975 had a detrimental effect on
de la civilisation, de la culture, des habitudes du Cambodge avant la prise de pouvoir par les Khmer Rouge.
The country prior to the coming to power of the Khmer Rouge. And I believe that it was Article 11 that specified the role of the president of the state presiding.
Encore une autre question. Avez-vous discuté avec M. Kyu-Sampan
du rôle qu'il a eu dans la
rédaction
de cette constitution?
Avez-vous écouté ses commentaires lorsqu'il a présenté lui-même cette constitution à la nation cambodgienne? Nous avons un rapport qui est assez intéressant à ce sujet, c'est le document E3-259.
E3-259.
Response. De précision.
I do not have any specifications to make. However, one general comment is that the state of heads, the speeches of heads of state do not, are rather broad. I believe that the speech that is delivered by the Queen of England is often drafted by the reigning government. And that in a communist regime, a head of state is essentially controlled by the Secretary General of the Communist Party and is controlled by the government.
Je ne sais pas si la reine d'Angleterre aurait prononcé ce que je m'apprête à lire, mais en tous les cas, c'est ce qui figure dans le document E3-273, et plus précisément à l'ERN
00-72-57-98.
S'agissant du chapitre 3 relatif au régime culturel, la culture du Cambodge démocratique et nationale, populaire, progressiste et saine, autant de traits distinctifs qui caractérisent la situation dans notre pays à présent. Il n'y a ni voleurs, ni ivrognes, ni vandales, ni prostituées dans notre pays. Pas un seul.
Vandalist, no prostitutes.
Notre culture a des traits nationalistes et populaires. C'est notre propre culture. Nous nous opposons aussi résolument à toutes les cultures corrompues et réactionnaires, des diverses classes opprimantes, de l'impérialisme et du colonialisme au Cambodge. Les films et les magazines qui répandaient cette culture corrompue et perverse ont disparu. Nous les avons complètement éradiqués, en même temps que les impérialistes étrangers. Nous nous habillons selon nos mœurs et nos traditions nationales, selon la réalité et les moyens qui sont ceux de notre peuple et de notre nation. Nous ne suivons pas aveuglément la mode pour imiter, pas plus que nous ne copions la culture décadente des impérialistes étrangers comme le faisaient ceux de la clique des traîtres de Lonnol. Regardez ce que ces traîtres de Lonnol ont fait à leurs partisans. À Phnom Penh, les maisons sont remplies d'objets inimaginables. Je ne sais pas comment les décrire. Ces maisons n'ont absolument aucun caractère national. C'est la raison pour laquelle nous nous opposons résolument à ce genre de culture. Si nous permettons à cette culture corrompue de gangréner notre pays, elle annihilera sûrement nos efforts pour défendre notre pays et protéger notre indépendance et notre souveraineté. Nous devons donc résolument rejeter la culture corrompue, réactionnaire de l'impérialisme et du colonialisme au Cambodge et par conséquent renforcer davantage encore la position de notre peuple. Dans le passé, notre peuple n'a cessé de lutter contre l'invasion de la culture corrompue des impérialistes étrangers. À l'avenir, nous devons continuer à lutter résolument pour préserver à tout prix notre culture progressiste, saine, nationale et populaire. Alors, est-ce que ça correspond à ce que M. Kyusankang pouvait dire quand il était à Paris ou quand vous l'avez rencontré?
Does this have any echoes, Mr. Witness, of what Mr. Kyusankang could have said in Paris during his studies and during the 1960s? Response. Just to return to the first sentence about defending popular culture and nationalist culture, yes, however, I heard him criticize the policy of absolute power, the absolute power of Prince Norodom Sihanouk. However, I did not hear him utter any virulent criticism of traditional Cambodian culture. On the other hand, when he was in Paris,
le gouvernement de Lon-Nol n'était pas encore en place, puisque c'était celui
de Lon-Nol government was not yet established, but it was well known that there had been many abuses during the 1970 to 1975 period, when
avec l'appui des Américains au Cambodge,
with the support of the Americans, a civil war was raging in Cambodia. Kyusankang was quite critical of the 1970 to 1975 period, which was absolutely devastating for Cambodia with the dropping of all of the American bombs.
Est-ce que Monsieur Kyusankang vous a dit pourquoi
ever tell you
il avait été nécessaire d'évacuer les villes après
to evacuate the cities following the liberation of Kampuchea?
Response.
He never talked to me about that. However, I have come to the following personal conclusion. After 1975, Phnom Penh was completely cut off and isolated from the external world. All supplies and commodities were being brought in by aircraft or by sea, and the Khmer Rouge had circled Phnom Penh, and they were simply unable to provide enough food to the population. Therefore, the evacuation of the cities took place in absolutely horrifying conditions. However, with hindsight, I do believe that it was out of economic need.
Pardon, j'ai cru comprendre que vous estimez que l'évacuation des villes était une nécessité économique. C'est bien ce que j'ai, vous avez dit.
The evacuation of the cities stems from an economic need. Is that what you said, sir? Response. Well, the city was receiving no supplies. Supplies were only coming in by boat or by plane. And when the Khmer Rouge took over, there was simply no more supplies of any sorts of commodities through any channel, be it air or water. Therefore, the population had to return to the countryside. But I recognize, based on what I've heard, that the evacuations occurred in the most ghastly conditions.
Donc pour vous, c'était quelque chose qui était tout à fait prévisible ou quelque chose qui vous a surpris quand vous avez entendu parler de cette évacuation des villes?
Foreseeable, or did it take, or was knowledge of this take you? Did knowledge of this take you by surprise? Response. Did not necessarily surprise me, but the conditions certainly appeared to me as horrible.
Est-ce que vous savez combien de lois ont été adoptées par l'Assemblée des représentants du peuple? Et est-ce que vous savez s'il y a eu des institutions judiciaires qui ont fonctionné pendant la période du Kampuchea démocratique?
Response. I do not know at all. You know, at the time that I was the managing director of financial services for the multinational Air Liquide, and so I was very busy with my work. I started my day at 7:30 and only ended at 8:30 in the evening. I was not working the 35-hour work weeks that we know today in France. I was entirely devoted, and essentially devoted to my work, and therefore I had very little knowledge of what was happening in Cambodia at the time.
Est-ce que on a parlé tout à l'heure de Insopan, Insopan? Est-ce que vous avez connu une personne qui s'appelait Insofip?
Did you know a person by the name of Insopip?
Answer:
Yes. I met him.
Est-ce que vous avez lu un ouvrage écrit par Monsieur Insofip qui s'appelle
Que son pan a grandi et réel? Enlarged and real? Answer: No, I have no knowledge of that publication, but I believe that it would be of interest to me.
Je le pense aussi. Je crois que à ce stade, je n'ai pas d'autres questions.
Mr. Witness, at this particular stage, I have no
questions. Sera bientôt versé au débat et pourra faire l'objet de
other questions will be put to you,
Monsieur le Président, je n'ai pas d'autres questions à poser au témoin et je remercie le témoin pour sa coopération.
To put to the witness, and I wish to thank him for his cooperation.
Thank you, Mr. Witness, and thank you, Judge Laverne. Mr. Witness, we will take a 20-minute break from now,
faire une pause de 20 minutes.
The local time here. It's 2:55 and
ici,
we shall resume at a quarter past 3 Cambodian time.
The court is now in recess.
From Gautier.